to be able to integrate VirtualBox with the Oracle Cloud Infrastructure, we need to be able to manage and create and delete resources from the cloud using VirtualBox and its interface. To do this, we need to create an API key pair so that VirtualBox can authenticate with the Oracle Cloud Infrastructure in order to be able to utilize and manage these resources. The VirtualBox documentation has a section about how to integrate VirtualBox with the Oracle Cloud Infrastructure, and it has details of how to create the keys and use the interface to upload your key to your user profile in the cloud console, and how to set up the VirtualBox profile in order to integrate with the Oracle Cloud Infrastructure. You can read all about this at this link to the VirtualBox documentation. So to begin, let's create the key pair. As I'm using VirtualBox on Microsoft Windows, I would need to install the openssl application. Another way to do it is I'm going to use Gitbash on my machine, which will provide a Linux environment and access to the openssl application. So the first thing we're going to do is create a directory where we can store our key files. We're going to call it API key. So we use the command mkdir API key. Let's change into that directory to prepare to create the key. We use the openssl command with the genrsa option, and we output with the dash out oci-api-key.pem for the file to be created. And we're going to create a file with a key length of 2048 bits. We could create bigger, but this is good enough for now. We're not generating a passphrase here, so we're not including that option in the command, so this should be sufficient. Pressing return, our key file is created, and we're returned to the command prompt. Next, we'll use the chmod command with 600 for the option to change the permissions for the file. So we're going to give the user read-write permission and the group and others no permissions. That's the private key created. So next, we're going to create the public key. We use the openssl command again with rsa-pubout-in and then the name of the private key, oci-api-key.pem, then the dash out option and specify the name of the public key to be created. After that's done, if we use the ls command, we can see both keys now created in our directory API key. Next, we need to upload our public key to our Oracle Cloud Infrastructure console user settings. There's an API keys section which allows us to upload the key or drag and drop the key so that our VirtualBox interface can integrate and operate with the Oracle Cloud Infrastructure and utilize and manage resources. To do this, we go to our profile information at the top right under our icon for our profile. Select user settings, scroll down to API keys, and here we have the option to add in an API key. Clicking on add API key, we get a dialog where we can have an API key pair generated for us, and we can then download the public and private keys, or we can choose to upload a public key, or we can paste in the contents of a public key into the dialog. Because we've already created the keys, we're going to check the choose public key file option. We open up our Windows Explorer to our API key folder, and we simply drag and drop our oci-api-key-public.pem file into the dialog. Here we can see the file has been uploaded. Now we click Add to add this key and associate it with our profile. So we click Add. This now gives us a configuration file preview window, giving us a fingerprint and also its association with our user profile and our profile-related components of the cloud console. There's also details of how this information can be used to create a config file on our system if required. We will use this information also in our VirtualBox cloud profile when we set it up, so let's go back to VirtualBox now and do that. Back on VirtualBox, we'll click on the Tools menu and then select Cloud. This now displays the OCI group, which is where any cloud VMs would be displayed. And we can see there's already an OCI profile configured. We can have multiple profiles here to work with different compartments and tenancies on our cloud infrastructure. And by simply ticking the box underneath list VMs, then we get to see those particular VMs associated with those profiles. To create a new profile, we click Add, which opens up a small dialog, which allows us to insert the name of the new profile we want to add. So I'm going to put in OCI API and click OK to create the profile. And here we can see it listed. If I click on the name of the profile, we can see it: user, the tenancy, the region, a passphrase if we created one for the key or not, the key file location for the private key on our local machine, the fingerprint of the key file that was used, and then a compartment to identify which resources we could use with this profile. For security reasons, as I set up the cloud profile, I will be partially obscuring parts of the OCID values. So first, let's add the user OCID. Returning to our console, we still have the configuration file preview. First, let's highlight our user OCID value, and then we'll paste that into our VirtualBox field. To paste it in, we simply double-click on the field, and that allows us to input something, either by typing or by pasting. Next, we'll get the tenancy information. Again, return our console file preview window, and we copy the tenancy OCID value. Next, we'll get the region information. So returning to our console, we copy the region value, US-Ashburn1, and go back to our VirtualBox profile and double-click and paste that in. As we didn't create a passphrase when creating the key, we don't have one to insert here, so it's not needed. So next, let's get the fingerprint for the key pair. Again, back to our console, and we copy the fingerprint information, return to our VBox, and double-click and paste that in also. Now we identify where the private key file is located on our local machine, where VBox is operating from. So we open up our Windows Explorer, go to our API key folder, and copy the name of the private key. Return to our profile. I type in the path to the folder, c:\api_key/, and then paste in the name of the file. And finally, we want to identify the compartment in our cloud from which VirtualBox will be managing resources in and requesting resources from. To get the compartment name, if we don't know it already, we can return to our console and close the configuration file preview window. Then we go to our cloud console menu, and on the home page, we can see that under recently visited, there's a link to compartments and identity. But if we didn't have this here, we could simply go down in the menu and find identity and security, and we'd be able to see compartments there also. So let's click on compartments identity. After waiting a few seconds, we get the full list of compartments. We have quite an extensive list here, actually 2 pages worth. So I'm going to go to the second page to find the one that I want to work with. Scrolling down to the bottom, I can see the name VirtDoc. Here I can very quickly get the OCID value for this compartment by hovering over the OCID value under the OCID column, and this gives us a pop-up with the option to copy the value directly from here. So let's click copy. And we return to our VirtualBox profile, double-click on the compartment field, and insert the OCID value for that compartment. Lastly, we click apply, and that's the profile created. So now let's just quickly go in and make sure that the profile is actually talking with the console. If we click on the OCI API group name, we get the options to create a new instance or add an instance. So let's just click on one of these. For instance, let's take the add machine option. This opens up the add cloud virtual machine dialog. And straight away, there should be communication between VirtualBox and our console using the API key to authenticate. We can see in the notifications window that a list of cloud source instances is being downloaded, which will then appear in the instances window. And there we go. That's our list of instances that has been downloaded. So that proves that we have got communication working using the API key to authenticate. And we now have our VirtualBox integrated with Oracle Cloud Infrastructure.